God's vision is nothing but to realize and feel His presence within yourself and everywhere around you, because God is an all-prevailing spirit permeating the entire universe. The manifested worlds are not different from Him, since they are, but His own expression in terms of name and form. Samarth Guru Ramdas. Always live on the strengths of your hard work. Do not crumble on the pieces of others. Samarth Guru Ramdas. Book name: Samarth Guru Ramdas. Book introduction: Samarth Guru Ramdas was an Indian Marathi Hindu saint, philosopher, poet, writer, and spiritual master. He was a devotee of Ram and Hanuman. He was born in Jalna district, Maharashtra, on the occasion of Ram Navami. He was born into a Marathi Brahmin family. His father died when Ramdas Ji was around 7 years of age. It is believed that he turned into an introvert after the demise of his father and was often noticed to be engrossed in thoughts about the divine. According to the legend, Ramdas Ji fled from his wedding ceremony upon hearing a pandit say the word Savdhan during a customary Hindu ritual. He spent 12 years, probably between 1621 and 1633, as an ascetic in complete devotion to Ram. He adhered to a rigorous daily routine during this period and devoted most of his time to meditation, worship, and exercise. He is thought to have attained enlightenment at the age of 24. Ramdas embarked on a pilgrimage across the Indian subcontinent. He travelled for 12 years, making observations on the life of everyday people. He had these observations recorded in two of his literary works, Asmani Sultaniya and Para Chakrani Rupan. These literary works provided insight into the prevalent social conditions in the Indian subcontinent. He also travelled to the Himalayas during this period. As part of his mission to redeem spirituality among the masses and unite the Hindu population, Ramdas Ji initiated the Samarth sect. He established several mathas, religious places or ashramas across the Indian subcontinent. He is claimed to have established around 700 to 1100 mathas, ashramas during his travels. He also had Hanuman temples built in other parts of Maharashtra and across the Indian subcontinent. Ramdas Ji had extensive literature written during his lifetime. His literary works include Dasbodh, Karunashtakas, Sundarkand, Yuddhakand, and many more. His compositions also include numerous aartis. One of his most popular aarti is Sukhkarta Dukharta, provider of happiness and removals of sadness for Lord Ganesh. He was an exponent of Bhakti Yoga or the path of devotion. According to him, total dedication to Ram brings about spiritual evolution. He emphasized the importance of physical strength and knowledge to our individual development. He expressed his admiration for warriors and highlighted their role in safeguarding society. He believed that the saints must not withdraw from society, but instead actively engage in social and moral transformation. Due to consistent foreign occupation, he aimed to re-associate the Hindu culture after its disintegration over several centuries. He also called for unity among the Marathas to preserve and promote the local culture. Ramdas Ji frequently expressed his abhorrence for distinctions based on caste and creed. He advocated for the abolition of the social classes. He encouraged the participation of women in religious works and offered them positions of authority. Few excerpts from the book. Once Ramdas Ji's mother forcefully took his consent for marriage and decided on a Brahmin girl for him. On the arranged date, all his relatives went and the wedding ceremony started. During the ceremony, when the Brahmin uttered the word Savdhan, alert, as a part of the ritual, Ramdas Ji thought, why is the Brahmin saying alert loudly? Is he trying to warn me that this bondage is for a lifetime and I will never be able to free myself lifelong? Thinking like this, he ran away from the marriage. People ran after him but could not catch this Hanuman Bhakta. His brother counseled his mother that Ramdas Ji will be happy wherever he is, and he is determined to walk on the path of spirituality, so don't force him to marry. He tried to understand the mental status of the general public and concluded that they have to be motivated to follow the path of karma. Those people who say that the world is mithya and go and sit in a far secluded place are totally wrong about the development of the country and religion. The need of the hour was such social workers who will fight against unfavorable circumstances and motivate others too. Samarth Guru Ramdas Ji advised the sadhus and householders regarding their duties. According to him, true householders were the main support of the society and they were needed for the development of the country. He warned the sadhus that if they had renounced their families and home for serving society and religion, for doing their best to protect and uplift the people, their sacrifice was praiseworthy. Otherwise, they would be called mad impostors or beggars. Good governance is one that punishes the wicked and protects the law-abiding citizens and sees that laws are adequately followed. The top quality of sadhu is that he knows who he is actually. In spite of living in society, he is not attached to it. Since he knows who he is not worried about the society. Few topics covered in the book fall in Hindu religion due to foreign rule. Aversion to marriage and leaving home. Sadhana in Panchavati. Observing the social situation by roaming all over the country. Visit various pilgrimage places. Protection of society is of prime importance.